In this figure, we'll look at mucosa-associated lymphatic tissue, or MALT. And this is one layer of defense against the microbes that come in by the millions in the food we eat every day. Now, those microbes are knocked down dramatically by the stomach acids. However, they are not knocked down to zero, and so there are some bacteria and other microbes that enter the small intestine and do have a chance to proliferate there. So what are our defense systems? Well, we have antimicrobial secretions within bile. The Paneth cells also secrete antimicrobial agents. We have tight junctions between our enterocytes of our gut lining here, right? Our luminal bacteria found out here. And so what we want to do is oppose their ability to pass between the cells in a paracellular fashion to enter our tissues. And so the tight junctions impede that movement. We also have a protective layer of mucus here. And at least in the small intestine, we have very high rates of peristaltic contractions that help move the chyme and the bacteria within it quite rapidly through these segments of the GI tract. In the colon, the peristaltic contractions slow down dramatically, and we'll actually find that the bacterial colonies increase dramatically in number there. Now, in addition to the protective mechanisms, we also have mechanisms of sampling this bacterial content and the food content as well for foreign antigens so that we can prepare an immune system response to those. And so we have a couple of cell types found in particular locations here that are sampling that content. You can see the glycocalyx is minimized or missing, our mucosal layer is thinner or missing, and we have access now to that bacterial and microbe content. And one thing that's going to happen is we're going to phagocytose, using dendritic cell projections here, those foreign antigens. And so we're going to phagocytose them. That's going to actually remove them, of course. But the dendritic cell is an antigen-presenting cell. It's going to digest that bacterium and then present components of it to the B and T lymphocytes that are found underlying this mucosal layer. And so we're helping to potentially activate an acquired immune system response with the B and T lymphocytes. Now remember, the dendritic cells are an innate response, right? These are innate immune system cells. They're going to respond to anything foreign. They're very generic in their response. Anything non-us will be phagocytosed and removed. The macrophages are also found here, tissue macrophages, this guy in yellow here. They're also phagocytic. However, they don't have these long projections, so they're going to rely on the M cells that are also doing this sort of gut sampling activity. They're endocytosing food particles and bacterium, and then presenting those components to the dendritic cells, sort of the indirect way to get to the dendritic cells, and the macrophages. Neutrophils could also be here phagocytosing these components. And then if they become excessive, if we get a dramatic stimulation and a lot of antigen presentation to the lymphocytes, we'll get activated B and T cells that go off into the circulatory system to become activated. And then it will return to mucosal layers where these infections are occurring, helping to defend against those particular pathogens. Now, when we get from the small intestine to the large intestine with that slowdown in peristalsis, the bacterial colonies go up dramatically. And so we have to have protections there in the late small intestine, the ileum, and those are known as Peyer's patches. This is a region within the MALT, the mucosa-associated lymphatic tissue, where we have a very specific organization of the lymphatic tissue there. And it makes sense that we have this high-density lymphatic tissue at the region where we have fast peristalsis junctioning with slow peristalsis in the colon. We actually have an ileocecal valve right there between those two regions, helping to oppose the backwards movement of the colon contents with the high bacterial numbers into the small intestine, where we could cause much greater problems.